Our army camp at URI had been attacked. This huge anger in the country against Pakistan-sponsored terrorism, this emotions of a nation running high, the leadership was agitated, my soldiers wanted revenge. All the four terrorists were shot dead, but we lost 18 soldiers. The next encounter with terrorists, I did not wear a bulletproof jacket. It was a Sunday. Early in the morning, the phone rang. Sleepily, I picked it up. When I heard what I heard, I was jolted. I was wide awake. Our army camp at URI had been attacked, and we had suffered heavy casualties. I woke up. I started getting ready. There were more phone calls. More news started pouring in. Bad news. 18 September 2016. In a suicide attack, four terrorists managed to barge into an army camp very close to the LOC, and we suffered heavy losses. All the four terrorists were shot dead, but we lost 18 soldiers. One died later in the hospital next day. I can still feel the pain because it happened on my watch. I was the co-commander in Srinagar, in charge of all the army deployed in whole of Kashmir when this happened. By the time I reached URI by a chopper, the firing had stopped, but the fires were still raging. LPG cylinder had caught fire, had exploded, and a soldier's cookhouse was on fire. Reinforcements were sent, operations were launched in the nearby jungles to flush out any lurking terrorists that might be there. Reinforcements were sent, the special forces also, the paracommandos. The dead and the wounded had been moved to the hospital. So much dust and smoke. The army chief landed up within a few hours. Later in the afternoon, the defense minister, the Honorable Raksha Mantri, also flew in. My superiors wanted answers. My soldiers, my units were looking up to me for orders. Press statements had to be issued. We had to, the families had to be informed. We had to make arrangements for the mortal remains of the families to be flown to their homes. With all that going on, I had to stay calm. I had to stay calm and not give in to the gloom. The first time that day I got a few minutes to myself was when I was accompanying the defense minister from the airport on a brief chopper ride to my headquarters in Badami Bagh, Kent. Because one cannot talk over the din or the rotor noise of the chopper, I thought to myself, had I not overcome failures earlier in my life? I was thinking, how can we overcome? How can we turn this pain into an opportunity? This huge anger in the country against Pakistan-sponsored terrorism, this emotions of a nation running high, the leadership was agitated, my soldiers wanted revenge. We convinced the leadership in my office that day of the need for a very bold riposte. We planned the biggest revenge ever. And in 10 days, surgical strikes were launched. 10 days of thorough planning and preparation, so much coordination and training, and more training and practice. Everyone worked so hard at it. That thorough planning and preparation paid off, and God was kind. We did not have a single casualty to our soldiers. I think fortune favors the brave. Army teaches you this. Army teaches us leaders the ability to look for opportunities in every failure. Army teaches its leaders the value of preparation and planning. My name is Lieutenant General Satish Dua. I retired as the Chief of Integrated Defense Staff a few months ago, where I had moved on promotion after the surgical strikes. But I had a very ordinary childhood, humble beginnings. My father was a refugee from Pakistan in 1947. He enlisted in the Air Force. He was an aircraft engine mechanic, but he was very good at his work. So good that his superiors would swear by him. I picked up a great sense of duty from my father. He dreamt big for his children. He made us dream big and have aspirations. After my schooling, I got a scholarship seat in a medical college in Karnataka. But my heart was set on NDA, the National Defense Academy. Everyone said, oh, you'd be a fool to pass it up. Medical seat koi chhodta hai kya? And at that impressionable age, I joined the medical college. I started MBBS. But just a couple of months before that, somebody had given me this book which I read called Reach for the Sky by Paul Brickhill. It is a story of Douglas Bader, a British daredevil Royal Air Force pilot who lost both his legs in an air crash. He then fought his way into the cockpit with two wooden legs and he flew for the RAF again. He was a daredevil pilot. He would fly several sorties into the enemy territory until he was shot down and he ejected in Germany. He was taken a prisoner of war. As a prisoner of war, he escaped from a prison, not once, several times. A man with two wooden legs escaping from a prison. I was so inspired by that story and I wanted to be a pilot. So while I was in the medical college, I went ahead for my selections. I got selected for NDA and I convinced my parents after a few months that I need to join NDA. I joined NDA, the National Defense Academy. In NDA, later, I changed over from Air Force to the Army. Now, when I joined the Army, I was commissioned as an officer in 8th Jackalai, my battalion, 8th Battalion, the Jammu and Kashmir Light Infantry. A rare battalion with a tag, officially a tag of bravest of the brave. My battalion was raised as a volunteer force during the 1947-48 operations. In 1971, our battalion tenaciously held on to a very strategic piece of ground on the line of control in JNK when all other units were suffering reverses. We have two battle honors awarded to us by the country for that battle. So when I joined the unit, I was brought up amongst heroes. I owe my grooming as a soldier to all of them. You know, in the Army, it is the ultimate aspiration of an infantry officer to one day command his own unit, his own battalion, the battalion that he was commissioned in. And the second is to lead his men in war, in operations. God was kind. I got both. In 1998, when I was promoted to a colonel, I became the commanding officer of my own battalion. And we had just less than a month ago, just moved in to a very operationally active area on the line of control in JNK. Within 1 week of my assuming command, we had our first encounter with terrorists. And I lost an officer. The morale of the battalion fell down. I was shattered myself. How would I face his family? How would I face my unit? I just couldn't sleep that night. So next morning, I collected my troops. I collected all my soldiers together and I addressed them. I said, yesterday, we lost a brave young officer who took a bullet in his chest while leading from the front. But all the three terrorists were neutralized. Not a single one escaped. His bravery has saved the lives of some of our soldiers and some locals. He was a hero. Now, how will we pay homage to such a hero? By neutralizing more and more terrorists. Now, little did I know that my words would prove to be prophetic. During my command tenure over the next couple of years in that area, we have 106 terrorists to our credit, which is a record of sorts in J&K. How did we do it? Now, looking back, I see now more clearly how we did what we did. In our second encounter, the next encounter with terrorists, I did not wear a bulletproof jacket. It is against the orders. I was acting braver than I felt. But seeing the commanding officer move in the front, leading from the front, taking great personal risk, that galvanized the soldiers. I saw a very different energy amongst my soldiers, my officers. And then it stoked up a positive spiral of bravery. There was no looking back for a battalion after that. It was a risk I took, but it could have gone horribly wrong. I could have just taken the first bullet and the show would have been over. But you need to take a risk. Sometimes I decided to take a risk to boost their morale and to bring in Josh. This encounter in which we lost Major Rohit Sharma has taught me several valuable life lessons, which I have been able to apply in my career, in my soldierly life thereafter, several times. Another thing that happened was when we were packing up Rohit's belongings to send them to his family, we came across an application form for B.Ed. in Jammu University, filled up by his wife. He had been married just 2 years. After the initial grief was over, after a few days, I went to his house in Jalandhar, met his wife and parents. I convinced her to do her B.Ed. as her husband's last wish. She was very reluctant initially, but we persuaded her and we helped her complete or go through her B.Ed. And one also realizes in army, when you are a leader, you lead the entire ecosystem, not just the soldier, not just the officers, but also their families. When you are a leader, when you lead the team, lead from the front, nothing inspires your team more. Nothing inspires any team more than that. And have it in you to take risks. While you must do thorough planning and preparation for whatever task you set out to do, but have it in you to take risk if it is required to boost the morale or to bring in Josh. Look at the risk that the leadership of this country has taken to launch these airstrikes after the Pulwama terror attack. And the Josh in our country is at all times high today. When I look at the youth, it fills up my heart with pride, a lot of confidence. You are going to drive the growth story of India. You are going to take India forward. You are going to take the world forward. So dream big, have aspirations, and work hard towards it. There will be upsets. There will be failures, the challenges. Look for opportunities in all these failures, in all these upsets. and work hard to achieve them. On that Joshila note, Jai Hind.
Tell us what you think about this video and don't forget to like, share and subscribe.